Hello, Team Jesus! I'm so excited today! Let's get started to our spiritual journey from day 1! Tara, samahan niyo ko! Basahin na natin! This is the book of the Purpose-Driven Life by Rick Warren. Yan, bubuksan na natin. Rick Warren, The Purpose-Driven Life, What on Earth Am I Here For? Let's start on this. Let's read. What on earth am I here for? A life devoted to things is a dead life. A stump, a God-shaped life, is a flourishing tree. Proverbs 2, verse 28. Blessed are those who trust in the Lord. They are like trees planted along a river bank, with roots that reach deep into the water. Such trees are not bothered by the heat or worried by long months of drought. Their leaves stay green and they go right on producing delicious fruit. Jeremiah 17 verse 7 to 8. And this is the journey of day 1. It all starts with God. For everything, absolutely everything, above and below, visible and invisible, everything got started in Him and finds its purpose in Him. Colossians 1 verse 16. Unless you assume a God, the questions of life's purpose is meaningless. Bertrand Russell, atheist. It's not about you. The purpose of your life is far greater than your own personal fulfillment, your peace of mind, or even your happiness. It's far greater than your family, your career, or even your wildest dreams and ambitions. If you want to know why you were placed on this planet, you must begin with God. You were born by His purpose and for His purpose. The search for the purpose of life has puzzled people for thousands of years. That's because we typically begin at the wrong starting point, ourselves. Yeah, nagsisimula tayo sa ourselves at yun pala yung mali pala siya. We ask self-centered questions like, what do I want to be? What should I do with my life? What are my goals, my ambitions, my dreams for my future? But focusing on ourselves will never reveal our life's purpose. The Bible says, it is God who directs the lives of His creatures. Everyone's life is in His power. Contrary to what many popular books, movies, and seminars tell you, you won't discover your life's meaning by looking within yourself. You've probably tried that already. You didn't create yourself, so there is no way you can tell yourself what you were created for. If I handed you an invention you had never seen before, you wouldn't know its purpose, and the invention itself wouldn't be able to tell you either. Only the creator or the owner's manual could reveal its purpose. Sabi dito, focusing on ourselves will never reveal our life's purpose. Yan, pag pala self-centered tayo, puro sa self tayo nagpo-focus, hindi marireveal sa atin yung tunay na purpose kung bakit tayo nandito sa mundo. Sabi dito, I once got lost in the mountains. When they stopped to ask for directions to the campsite, I was told, "You can't get there from here. You must start from the other side of the mountain." In the same way, you cannot arrive at your life's purpose by starting with a focus on yourself. You must begin with God, your Creator. You exist only because God wills that you exist. You were made by God and for God, and until you understand that, life will never make sense. It is only in God that we discover our origin, our identity, our meaning, our purpose, our significance, and our destiny. Every other path leads to a dead end. Yan. Many people try to use God for their own self-actualization, but that is a reversal of nature and is doomed to failure. You were made for God, not vice versa. And life is about letting God use you for His purposes, not you're using Him for your own purpose. Yan, parang sinasabi dito na hindi pwedeng ginagamit mo siya para sa own purpose natin. Ginawa niya tayo para sa purpose ni God para sa atin. The Bible says, obsession with self in these matters is a dead end. Attention to God leads us out into the open, into a spacious, free life. I have read many books that suggest ways to discover the purpose of my life. All of them could be classified as self-help books, because they approach the subject from a self-centered viewpoint. Self-help books, even Christian ones, usually offer the same predictable steps to finding your life's purpose. Consider your dreams, clarify your values, set some goals. Figure out what you are good at, aim high, go for it, be disciplined, believe you can achieve your goals, involve others, never give up. Of course, these recommendations often lead to great success. You can usually succeed in reaching a goal if you put your mind to it. But being successful and fulfilling your life's purpose are not at all the same issue. You could reach all your personal goals, becoming a raving success by the world's standard, and still miss the purposes for which God created you. You need more than self-help advice. The Bible says, self-help is no help at all. Self-sacrifice is the way, my way, to finding yourself, your true self. This is not a self-help book. It is not about finding the right career, achieving your dreams, or planning your life. It is not about how to cram more activities into an overloaded schedule. Actually, it will teach you how to do less in life. Yan, tuturuan daw tayo na mas to do less in life, yung mas konti yung gagawin para ma-maximize natin yung buhay natin at oras dito sa mundo. By focusing on what matters most, it is about becoming what God created you to be. How then do you discover the purpose you were created for? You have only two options. Your first option is speculation. This is what most people choose. They conjecture, they guess, they theorize. When people say, "I've always thought life is," they mean, "This is the best guess I can come up with." Yan yung mga karaniwang sinasabi natin. For thousands of 4 years, brilliant philosophers have discussed and speculated about the meaning of life. Philosophy is an important subject and has its uses. But when it comes to determining the purpose of life, even the wisest philosophers are just guessing. Yan, kahit pala yung mga wise philosopher, nagge-guess lang sila. Tapos sabi dito, Dr. Hogg Moorhead, a philosophy professor at Northeastern Illinois University, once wrote to 250 of the best-known philosophers, scientists, writers, and intellectuals in the world. Sumulat siya sa mga 250 na mga kilalang tao na philosopher, scientists. Tingnan natin kung ano yung sinulat niya. Sabi dito, you were made by God and for God, and until you understand that, life will never make sense. Yan. Sabi dito, ginawa tayo ni si God ang gumawa sa atin at ginawa tayo para kay God. At hanggat hindi natin naiintindihan yun, yung life will never make sense. Hindi, yung buhay, hindi magkakaroon ng sense. Punta tayo sa next page. Tapos, sabi niya, asking them, what is the meaning of life? Ayan, sinulatan niya yung mga philosopher, tinanong niya, what is the meaning of life? He then published their responses in a book. Tapos, lahat ng mga sagot nila, ginawa niya sa isang libro. Sinulat niya sa isang libro. Some offered their best guesses. Some admitted that they just made up a purpose for life. Yung iba, gumawa lang sila ng sariling purpose nila sa buhay. And others were honest enough to say they were clueless. Ayan, yung iba, clueless sila. Hindi din nila alam. In fact, a number of famous intellectuals asked Professor Moorhead to write back and tell them if he discovered the purpose of life. Ayan yung iba, sinabihan siya na sulatan mo kami kung nalaman mo na yung na-discover mo na yung purpose of life. Sila na yung nagtatanong din. Fortunately, there is an alternative to speculation about the meaning and purpose of life. It's revelation. We can turn to what God has revealed about life in His Word. Yan. Pwedeng ma-reveal sa atin yung about life sa pamagitan ng Word ni God. Ayan, in His Word. The easiest way to discover the purpose of an invention is to ask the creator of it. Ito yung gusto ko. Sabi niya dito, di ba pag may inventor, yung invention, kunyari may na-inventong ilaw, para malaman natin kung paano yung tungkol sa ilaw na yun, ang, syempre, ang tatanungin natin yung inventor nun. Parang katulad sa atin, di ba, si God ang gumawa sa atin, ibig sabihin, siya yung mismong inventor sa atin at siya yung mas nakakaalam ng mga dapat nating gawin at yung purpose natin sa buhay. Nasaan tayo? The same is true for discovering your life's purpose. Ask God. Ayan. Tanungin natin si God kasi siya ang creator ng buhay natin. God has not left us in the dark to wonder and guess. Yan, hindi naman daw tayo nilalang dito na para manghula na lang at mag-guess kung ano nga ba bakit tayo nabubuhay dito sa mundo. He has clearly revealed His 5 purposes for our lives through the Bible. It is our owner's manual explaining why we are alive, how life works, what to avoid, and what to expect in the future. It explains what no self-help or philosophy book could know. The Bible says, God's wisdom goes deep into the interior of His purposes. It's not the latest message, but more like the oldest. What God determined as the way to bring out His best in us. God is not just the starting point of your life. He is the source of it. Yan, hindi lang nagumpisa kay God yung buhay natin. Siya yung source of it. Siya yung pinagmumulan ng buhay natin. Hindi lang nagumpisa dahil siya ang gumawa sa atin, kundi siya yung pinagmumulan ng buhay natin. To discover your purpose in life, you must turn to God's Word. Yan. Para ma-discover natin talaga yung purpose ng buhay natin, kailangan nating pumunta sa salita ni God, yung na makikita natin sa Bible. Alamin natin yung mga sinasabi niya. Not the world's wisdom. Hindi daw yung wisdom ng mundo. Kasi minsan may mga haka-hakay tayong mga tao, mga sarili lang nating wisdom. At yung iba, pwedeng mali at wisdom lang ng tao. You must build your life on eternal truths. Yan. Yung eternal truths, yung buhay na walang hanggan na katotohanan. Yung mas malalim na eternal truths, makikita sa Bible. Not pop, psychology, success motivation, or inspirational stories. Hindi siya yung inspirational stories lang na imbento. Totoo siya. The Bible says, it's in Christ that we find out who we are and what we are living for. Long before we first heard of Christ and got our hopes up, He had His eyes on us, had designs on us for glorious living. Part of the overall purpose, He is working out in everything and everyone. This verse gives us three insights into your purpose. Sabi dito sa day one, it all starts with God. Yan, yung purpose natin nag-i-starts, it all starts with God. Number one, you discover your identity and purpose through a relationship with Jesus Christ. Yan. Kailangan natin magkaroon ng relationship kay Jesus Christ. Yung para maging close talaga tayo sa Kanya at makilala talaga natin siya. Hindi lang kilala bilang alam natin na siya ay yung God o Panginoon, pero yung alamin natin yung buhay niya, tapos kung paano siya mag-isip, at pag nagbasa tayo ng Bible, malalaman natin yun. If you don't have such a relationship, I will later explain how to begin one. Ayan, mamaya i-explain kung wala pa tayong relationship talaga na ganun kay Jesus, dadako tayo dun mamaya. At number two, God was thinking of you long before you ever thought about Him. Ayan, kahit hindi mo pa siya naiisip ngayon, bata ka pa lang, iniisip ka niya na. His purpose for your life predates your conception. He planned it before you existed. Ayan, bago ka pa mag-exist sa mundo na to, tayo, pinalano niya na kung paano tayo mag-i-exist without your input. Kahit wala na ng input mo, kahit di mo sinasabi na gusto kong mabuhay, siya na mismo yung nagplano ng buhay natin. You may choose your career, your spouse, your hobbies, and many other parts of your life. But you don't get to choose your purpose. Ayan, pwede daw nating piliin yung career natin, kung sino yung pwede nating maging asawa, yung gusto nating hobbies, o ano pang parte ng buhay natin na pwede nating piliin. Pero ang isang hindi natin pwedeng piliin ay kung ano ba talaga yung purpose natin. Kasi si God lang nakakaalam kung ano nga ba yung purpose natin dito sa mundong ito. Number three, the purpose of your life fits into a much larger cosmic purpose that God has designed for eternity. That's what this book is about. Yan. Andrei Bitov, a Russian novelist, grew up under an atheistic communist regime. But God got his attention one dreary day. Ayan. He recalls, in my 27th year, while riding the metro in Leningrad, now St. Petersburg, I was overcome with a despair so great that life seemed to stop at once, preempting the future entirely, let alone any meaning. Suddenly, all by itself, a phrase appeared. Ayan, bigla siyang may nakita nung parang nawawala na siya ng pag-asa sa buhay na siguro nagmumuni-muni siya. At yung nabasa niya, nakalagay, "Without God, life makes no sense." Ayan, sabi, "Without God, life makes no sense." Repeating it in astonishment, I rode the praise up like a moving staircase, got out of the metro, and walked into God's light. Ayan, simula nung nabasa na yun, parang hinit siya so hard nung salita na yun na kung wala si God, life makes no sense. Wala nang sense yung buhay. Kasi nga naman, paano doon nga tayo nagmula kay God. Paano tayo mabubuhay kung wala si God? Parang siguro ganun. Tapos, nagkaroon ng kaliwanagan sa buhay niya at lumakad na siya. Doon nag-start na lumakad siya sa kalooban ng Panginoon, sa patungo kay God, sa liwanag ni God. You may have felt in the dark about your purpose in life. Congratulations! You're about to walk into the light. At ayan, congratulations! Makakalakad na tayo sa liwanag. Sisimulan natin sa ating journey na ito. Day 1. Thinking about my purpose. Point to ponder. It's not about me. Ayan, ito yung kailangan nating tandaan. It's not about me. Hindi sa sarili natin. It's all about God. At verse to remember, everything God started in Him and find its purpose in Him. Colossians 1 verse 16. Questions to consider. In spite of all the advertising around me, how can I remind myself that life is really about living for God, not myself? Ayan, tapos na tayo! Ang question ngayon, kailangan nating tandaan, pag bubulay-bulay natin ay, in spite sa mga nangyayari sa buhay natin, paano natin papaalalahanan yung sarili natin that life, yung buhay ay is about living for God, mamuhay para kay God, hindi lang para sa sarili natin, not myself. Yan yung dapat nating ngayong matutunan at i-apply natin sa araw na ito. Point to ponder, always remember, it's not about me. Yan, tapos na!